Hey folks, Michael Mann from Michael Mann Security Services. Episode 14, the Protector Series. We continue to go because of questions. We're gonna talk about the law enforcement response to an active shooter event. And all we're gonna discuss here, two types of response, why immediate response or having a church security team is important. You've seen this, talked about it before. The risk is very, very low, but I just wanna go over the two types of response and what that really looks like, okay? All right, so again, episode 14 in our protector series. All right, so law enforcement response to some sort of violent event, okay? So understand just really quickly, there's two types of response we talk about responding to these violent events. Number one is immediate. Immediate response can be a couple of things. So immediate means someone is on scene or on site when the shooting begins. Now, that can be a church security team, like what we saw in December, or back in December 2019, at the church shooting just outside of Fort Worth, Texas. That also happened in 2007 at New Life Church in Colorado. Now understand, even with immediate response, you're still just mitigating the impact. The most important part of this is prevention, understanding what you need to look for 2 weeks, 2 months before the shooter comes on scene. But having an immediate response does lessen that impact, or mitigates that, more than what this other type of response we talk about, law enforcement. So immediate response can be done by you. It can be done by an off-duty police officer that's in the audience. It can be done by someone with a carry permit that happens to be in the congregation or in the audience when this takes place. Or just happen, maybe there's a police officer outside in the parking lot and they can also provide that immediate response. So immediate response means right then or just seconds after the shooting starts, someone is able to respond and try to neutralize the threat, all right? So that's what church security teams are there to provide if you decide to take the risk and put armed teams on site, all right? That second type of response is delayed, and that's done by somebody that is off-site. That's most of the time we call 911, when for those guys in uniform, in blue, brown, whatever color they wear in your city or county, for those folks to show up and provide a response and neutralize the threat. Here is the issue or the vulnerabilities when we talk about delayed response. Now, understand, church security leaders that are watching this video and have watched my other videos, I'm not telling you to go use armed security teams. I'm just letting you know the two types of response and the vulnerabilities associated with waiting on a response to come from offsite. All right. Again, all of this is about prevention. It is not about response. The most important training that your security team can receive is training on field threat assessments, or what we call the Israeli security concept, and medical response training, and probably training from your greeters on how to greet people. That's what you need up front to prevent the events. All right. So when we talk about delayed response vulnerabilities, understand statistically 80% of all active shooter events are over before the police even get there. All right, that's not from me. That's not from Michael Mann Security Services. That is straight from the U.S. Department of Justice's study on active shooter response. You got to dig in there and you got to look and figure it out. That doesn't give you that percentage. Number two, when the police do get there, And the active shooter or that violent adversary is still inside the target area shooting and he decides he wants to fight, the police take at least a 46% casualty rate. That means almost half of the police officers that show up to get inside that target area to engage that active shooter, almost half of those folks are gonna take casualties. They're gonna get shot. They're gonna get severely injured. They could get killed, or they could get shot. Maybe they're not severely injured, but it's enough to take them out of the fight. So understand 46% casualty rate when the LEOs or police officers enter that target area, the active shooter is still in there shooting. Because it's dangerous, they are conducting a stronghold assault, which is the most dangerous form of assault or assault option in the types of assaults that special operations or SWAT teams would conduct, all right? The immediate response provides what we call a denial strategy, trying to deny that person from gaining access to those targets or to those assets that we're trying to protect. And that first element in that is always prevention, not this, all right? Response requirements. This is another reason why this happens, the 46% casualty rate and why 80% of all active shooter events are over before the police get there. There's some requirements for response. Number one, they have to be notified of it, and there's always a delay. There's always a delay of getting that information to a communications person, then to a dispatcher, then dispatching the police department, okay? The next element is going to be deployment. They have to get from where they are to you and into that target area to be able to try to stop the threat. So not only do they have to get a accurate and a quick communication, which that never happens when you call 911, and not any fault of their own, it's just all the layers that you have to go through. Now they have to get from where they were to where you are inside that target area to stop the threat, and there's always going to be a delay. And that last requirement for response is going to be neutralization. What that means is actions taken by the responders to neutralize the threat or stop that threat. That means they have to get in there and stop it. And because it's a stronghold assault, it requires a number of other elements we're not going to talk about today, all right, because this is a SWAT school or an active shooter school, but it requires a lot to be able to stop that active shooter. Knowledge, skills, ability, equipment, a lot of the things that law enforcement officers in the United States of America, based on our form of government, just do not have. They're not ready for it. Okay? So these are the basics of law enforcement response. If you have any questions, you can contact us at michaelmannsecurityservices.com. Go to, it's actually, you can go to Scott at michaelmannsecurityservices.com or Scott M at michaelmannsecurityservices.com. Scott will answer all your questions. You can give us a call. Scott will call you back. Or you can see us on Facebook and Instagram at Safe with Mann. Hey, there's a case study from a shooting a couple years ago at a synagogue in Pittsburgh. If you email us at Scott or at ScottM at MichaelMannSecurityServices.com, Scott's going to send you the link to that case study, and you can read about that and look at the casualty rate, what we just talked about. All right? Hey, thanks for tuning in. And remember, folks, it's about prevention, not response.